To unleash Unity's 2D animation package full potential, we can interact with it through scripts. In this video, we will learn how to swap character sprites programmatically, inject a custom sprite into an existing character, replace all sprites as a grouped skin, and finally, create a mixer for composing various characters. In the previous video, we saw how we could work manually with the 2D animation package's components. To briefly recap, a sprite library asset contains all sprites and their variants, organized into categories and accessible by labels. Not to confuse, but there is also a sprite library component, which attaches the sprite library asset to the character. A sprite resolver allows us to switch sprites by selecting the active variant from the library asset. In our first demo, we will start by randomly selecting a head sprite. I created a new mono behavior and added three inspector fields, a sprite library, sprite resolver, and a category name. In the editor, I've attached the component to the character. I assigned it the character sprite library, the head sprite resolver, and filled in the head category name. Back in the script, I created a property to quickly access the library asset. The random swap method is straightforward. I query for the available labels given the head category name. I convert them into an array for direct access to the elements. I then select a random index and use it to retrieve a label name for the label collection. Finally, I call setCategoryAndLabel to set the chosen label as the active variant for the head category. This script is ready, and all that remains is to add a UI button and call the method on the character. We have now randomly selected a head. We'll continue this demo by injecting a custom head sprite, which we hadn't defined a label for beforehand. In the existing script, I added a new method that accepts a sprite parameter. The first step is to add a new variant to the sprite library. To do so, I call addOverride and pass the custom sprite, the target category, and the new label. Now, I once again call setCategoryAndLabel with the new label we created. I added a new button, which calls the new method we created, passing it a custom sprite. Now, when clicking the button, it should... Yeah, here's the thing. You see, when we rigged our character in the previous video, we created metadata of the bones and how they are bound to the sprite. A sprite consists of a reference to the texture, and alongside it, the rigging metadata. When we injected the custom sprite, it had the texture reference, but was missing the rigging metadata. In the script, before injecting the sprite, we should duplicate the rigging metadata. I retrieve an existing head sprite from the sprite library using the active label. I then get the rigging metadata from the existing head, both the bones and the bind poses. And finally, set the custom head's bones and bind poses. We can now select a random head or inject a custom one. It's worth noting that you can skip the rig duplication step by duplicating the bones manually. The previous video demos how to do it. Before creating a character mixer, let's look into replacing all the character sprites as a grouped skin. The recommended approach for this is to replace the library asset as a whole. We first need to create multiple libraries, each consisting of the same categories but different sprites. In a newly created mono behavior, I added a using statement at the top of the file. It's required for all the scripts in the project, allowing us to interact with the 2D animation package components. For those using Unity 2021 and later, the components are no longer under the experimental namespace. I added a sprite library inspector field, and also created the only method we need for this script, containing a library asset parameter. All I do in this method is passing the new library asset to the sprite library component. Yep, that's all. While this workflow is mostly editor work, it's great for downloading asset bundles with new skins over the network, reusing existing animated characters. In our final demo, we will create a mixer to mix and match sprites to create various characters. We need a way to store all the available categories, so I created the serialized struct mixer category with three inspector fields: category name, display title, and sprite resolver. For the drop-down UI, I created another mono behavior, consisting of two inspector fields, UI text and UI drop-down. We will use this script to control a mixer selector prefab. It has a single method that accepts two parameters, the mixer category serialized struct we previously created, and an array of labels. I start by setting the UI label to the title provided by the mixer category struct. Next up, I create an empty list of UI dropdown option data. For each label passed to the method, I make a new dropdown option data and add it to the list. I then assign the list to the UI dropdown's option property. Last, I hook up a listener for when the dropdown value changes. In such a case, we will receive the index of the selected item. I can then use the index to retrieve a label from the labels array. The label is then assigned as the active variant of the sprite resolver using set category and label. I created a UI canvas prefab and attached the mixer selector component we just created. I added a label and a dropdown UI elements to the prefab and assigned them to the component. Hang on there, we have one last script to create. The last mono behavior is the mixer that manages the whole operation. It has three inspector fields, a sprite library, a mixer selector script we just created, and an array of mixer category structs we made before. I also create a method that accepts a mixer category for which I will create a mixer selector instance. I start by retrieving an array of labels for the category. I get them by calling getCategoryLabelNames on the library asset that I access through the sprite library. I then use the prefab reference to instantiate a new mixer selector as a child of the script's transform. I call the init method we created and pass it the category struct and the options labels. Finally, when the mono behavior starts, I iterate through the categories and create a selector for each of them. To hook it all up, I created a UI panel and attached to it the mixer component. I assigned the character sprite library and the mixer selector prefab we have created. I also filled in all the mixer category data for this character, including the category names, display titles, and the sprite resolvers from the character's objects. We can now create any sprite combination for our character. As always, the project is available to download from the description. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching!